This is the aquaponics project that my sons are doing in Northern California. This is a, how many gallons? A lot. 250 gallons of water in this tank and about 160 fish. And the fish were first gathered, they were tiny. Now they're several inches long. I don't know that we'll be able to see them, although it is feeding time, so there you go. And they're hungry. Oh, there you go. You can see them on the far end of the screen against the green background, how big they are now. Maybe it's about 159 fish since my son Trevor decided to eat one last week just to check it out. That was just delicious. It was really yummy. I got some and the bones were plentiful. So they'll be much more fun when they're a little larger. But the water is circulated through this tank. About 400 gallons of water circulate between here and where we're going to go next, which is over into the glaring sunshine here, where you'll see all kinds of things growing. Last time we did this, there were not so many plants, but now it's huge. So some of these plants are for food, and some of these plants are for attracting pollinating creatures. Now you might think that the nasturtiums with these fabulous blossoms, you can see that, love this color, are for pollinating, and they are, but they're also for eating. Delicious, spicy. And marigolds. And so we have sun plants and shade plants growing in the same place. Kind of crazy and cool, and it's working. Here are some purple peppers. Let's see if I can pull one out here so you can see this. Beautiful baby going on here. And corn, strawberries, purple basil. I'm tripping over stuff here. Some herbs. There's oregano in here. There is Swiss chard. Grazing is consistent. We want to see how big we can get these nasturtium leaves because we think they would make superb lettuce wraps. They're really pretty good. Let me just tell you how yummy they are. Now we've got peppers. Crunch, crunch. So good. All kinds of sizes because they're in continual growth. Basil, mustard green. Trying some different things to see how well they work. There's some pollinating going on right there. And over here, more flowers to attract all kinds of pollinating things. You see the herbs there. And we're growing eggplant. See that beautiful baby right there? Sorry, I'm still crunching on nasturtiums. All kinds of varieties of tomatoes. I'll stand back so you can see this a little bit. So they've created this nice netting backdrop for the tomatoes to be supported. And at the same time, because it's at an angle, can also dry things. So that's what's remaining of a very huge basil crop with some of the biggest basil leaves I've ever seen. Things grow very quickly and quite large. This kind of tomato is delicious. I ate one the other day. I might just eat this one. No, I'm gonna eat this one back over here. It's calling me. Come to mama. This is gonna be kind of a fun video with me crunching. So, we've got a variety of a type of Roma tomatoes, some heirlooms. And you can see, as I showed in the last video, that all the plants are in these clay pebbles. There's no potting mix here at all. So all the plants are secured with the clay pebbles. You can hear the water running. I don't know if you'll be able to see it very well. But it circulates between these several bins here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, as you can see here, it's running down from watering the strawberries and the basil right now. And it'll fill up one tank and then drain into the next. Such an efficient system. Strawberries, corn. Oh, here's that other pepper. I knew there was another one. It's a purple pepper. It's really purple. You know, when you buy them in the store, oftentimes the purple peppers look like this little guy here. If you can see him, they're kind of green and purple. But when you grow them this way, right out here in the sun and the healthy with good nutrients, we get purple. And we've tried some other things. There's some aloe in there in case anybody gets injured, needs something. So there you go. It's the Aquaponics Project in Northern California. In an update, I'll back up so we can see just how big this is. Thank you so much for visiting our video.